Instead of writing code, I want to talk about something, or rather, developing the language. That's why I'll be talking about self-healing applications in production in Kubernetes. So, a bit of an intro first. My name is Sheharyar Naseer, and I'm the co-manager of GDC Bangalore. So, again, thank you all for coming today. I'm also a backend engineer at this amazing company called Slab. There are also generous enough to sponsor this conference today. So what does it mean to have a self-healing application and why the heck should we care about it? Let's talk about a couple of issues first. You can make the best app in the world, but if your users can access it quickly and reliably, for that matter. The problem is that deployments are hard and even the best engineers struggle to do it right. You can run your code, more applications on your laptop, but scaling it to tens, hundreds, or maybe even thousands of nodes in production is the main challenge. Deployment to make sure everything is working smoothly, because shit happens all the time and sites go down all the time for tons of reasons, and there is your duty to bring them back online. For the engineers and DevOps people in this room, But imagine, the server constantly monitoring itself for issues and automatically fixing them when something does go wrong. You no longer get to draw for yourself, and you can finally begin to possibly have something for the life. Okay, so how do we do this? Well, the answer is Kubernetes. So the big question is, the Kubernetes hack or is the line of a mushkil field? Actually, not the reason I entered the Bangla, but what Kubernetes tries to do is, it tries to automate your infrastructure as much as possible with a minimal configuration. So it was open source that moved into 2014, and it monitors, detects, and rectifies issues in your cluster. And it does all of this by doing a declarative system, which I'm going to give you in just a bit. You buy a virtual private server from a cloud service company, you configure the environment, install dependencies, clone your application, and try to get it to work. Protocol automation view was appear with tools like Jenkins, Capistrano, Ansible, but you still need to explicitly tell it what to do. So imagine doing this every time for a mid-sized application that maybe has one background service, three primitive apps, and a service worker. The markup. And if your app does go down for whatever reason, again, you have to bring it back up online by giving it more instructions. Kubernetes is different. You don't tell Kubernetes do this, this, and this. Instead, you say, "Hi, John. Mujhe ye chahiye, laake do, mujhe nahi pata." And Kubernetes will say, "Ye aisa ho gaya." And I'm not even exaggerating. That's almost exactly how it works. It's concept to get the desired state. Because you just tell the system what you need and the system will make it happen for you. And if stuff breaks, Kubernetes will automatically try to recover it to the last breaking state. So before getting into the self-healing part, I want to touch slightly on the Kubernetes architecture itself. Subsequently, architecture images and containers.
If you know about Docker, it's basically just that. But for those who don't, a container is a very lightweight and a sandboxed application environment with the most necessary programs installed. A pod, on the other hand, is just a group of one or more containers together in the same virtual machine. They're tightly coupled, so there's very many in them. Finally, deployments define the desired state of your production environment. So this is the actual part where you tell the system what you want. Either you have Kubernetes ko batate hain ke mujhe ye ye cheeze chahiye, laake do. There are a couple more concepts like services, volumes, replica sets, but they're not important for this talk right now. But I highly suggest that you look them up after this. Coming back to deployments. Deployments, like I said, define the desired state of your production infrastructure. Jaise ke containers ke, kitne pod zone, ke replicas kis tarah se bane ho. So I keep saying desired state again and again. And here's a quick example of it. Left side pe ek demo app ki definition hai, jisme maine sirf ye bataya hai what's needed to run the application. For example, maine isko sirf ye bataya ki mujhe OpenJDK aka Java install chahiye. Meri app ki directory Kubernetes demo hai. Aur usko run karne ke liye mujhe compile jar banani hogi. So Kubernetes sari dependencies khud download karta hai, khud install karta hai, it compiles your applications for you and it runs it. Similarly, you, on the right side, you can see a very basic definition of a deployment. This deployment, I have Kubernetes ko bataya ki mujhe ek apni app ke 3 replicas chahiye, each running 2 containers. The first one being Nginx running on port 80, and the second one is my custom app that I just defined with a very high compute power of 600,000 megahertz and 24 gigs of RAM. And Kubernetes will make it happen for me. Well, as long as the infrastructure supports it. Okay, so finally, we can talk about self-healing. Exactly jis tarah Kubernetes ko batate hain, what our deployment should look like, we can also tell it what a healthy version of our app looks like. Kubernetes ye do tarah se kar sakta hai. One being the readiness check and one being the liveness check. Readiness matlab jab app set up hui hai, it's ready to accept, it's ready to start working or not. Or liveness matlab app sahi se chal rahi hai ya nahi. So once you tell Kubernetes ke what a healthy app looks like, it'll constantly monitor your application, or if shit hits the fan, it'll try to recover it. So both of these checks can be performed in 3 ways. So the first one is running a command in the container to check its exit code. Second is making a web request to your web server to see if it sends back a successful response. And the third one being trying to open a socket. Since most of us here are web developers, I'll just focus on the second one, the HTTP GET one. Both of these probes can be performed with just a few lines of YAML code. The health check config we use at Slab is actually much shorter than this. For example, either maine readiness mein bataya ke to check if my app is ready, all Kubernetes needs to do is just hit the slash ready URL path. And if it returns a successful response, that means my app is ready. Similarly, for liveness, it just needs to hit the slash healthy path on my web app. Iske alawa aur bhi zyada options hain, but Kubernetes takes care of most of the default ones, so you don't have to. But if you still want to customize them, you can. Ye slide literally meri puri talk ka crux hai. If you understand this, matlab meri aaj ki itni mehnat zaya nahi hui. If you don't, then what can happen? Then I can't do anything. Okay, so I will give a quick demo. Okay, so on the left side, there's a very deployment definition. I have an app made, whose name is Kubernetes demo. I'm running just one container. It's a pre-built container you can download to test your Kubernetes installation. Usse maine bataya ki I just need a port 8080 open. As an HTTP protocol. Isme maine do probes define kiye hain. One is the readiness probe and one is the liveness probe. Readiness probe mein maine again sirf ye bataya ki to check if my app is healthy, all it needs to do is check the slash ready path, and if it's healthy, to check the slash healthy path. Maine both minus configuration kiye, but you can again do a lot more with this. So what I'll do is, pehle main aapko so first I'll show you what an empty Kubernetes installation looks like. So I'll just run kubectl pods. So it says no resources found because we haven't actually set up our application yet. So I can just apply this deployment to kubectl, which is the binary Kubernetes uses to manage all of its configurations. So kubectl apply, there you go. So just so using the configuration on the left, it just created our deployment on the Kubernetes installation. So if I check pods again, it says the pod is ready and it's running. So let's try something. If I try to delete this pod manually, Kubernetes will know that something is wrong, that pod has crashed, and it will try to restart it back again. So if I manually try to delete this pod, let me just copy this value from here. Actually, before that, let me run this in watch mode so you can see whenever any changes are made. So jab bhi pods mein koi changes hogi, so it'll print a new line. So I'll just paste the value of the pod here. I managed to manually pod delete key there, so Kubernetes knew that something is wrong, it doesn't match the desired state. Usne usko automatically terminate kiya jo existing pod tha aur uski jagah usne naya pod create kiya. So ab is state se aane mein, is state mein hame takriban 5 seconds lage hain because we specified that in our configuration as the initial delay. 5 second baad wo check karta hai if the app is ready to be actually used or not. Aur uske baad uska status us change kar deta to running. Okay, so I have this app running in production. So ye ek sirf demo app hai to test my Kubernetes installation. So I'll go to the liveness probe here. So Kubernetes har 5 second baad app ko ping karta hai liveness route pe to check if it's working or not. Actually, I think it's 10 seconds. Let me look at the configuration again. Yes, it's 10 seconds. So if I manually fail this, so ab ye maine manually se kaha ki whenever it receives a request to check if the app is working correctly or not, wo usko kahega ki app fail ho rahi hai. So assuming our actual app in production failed, just ठीक है अब Kubernetes को पता चल गया कि the app is not working because it's failing the liveness check. तो उसने app को force restart किया है and it got it back to working, back to a working state. And that's pretty much it. Let me switch back. So before I end, does anyone have any questions? Go ahead.
How is it different from Docker?
Excellent question. So Docker is basically a containerization tool. And Kubernetes is a containerization management tool. So Kubernetes can work with Docker and other container systems too. So they go hand in hand. So Docker se aap sirf ek container manage karte, aap images define karte. Jo maine aapko pehle left side pe image ki definition dikhai thi, that was a Docker image. So wo baad mein pod ke andar as a container execute hoti hai, and you can manage multiple pods using that. Does that answer your question?
Yes, thank you.
Does anyone have the questions? Ya koi yahi pooch lo Kubernetes ka matlab kya hai? Nahi? Chalo yaar bata deta hu. So Kubernetes is ancient Greek for pilot or the helmsman of a ship. So you know, makes sense. Kubernetes helps you navigate the murky waters of containerization and DevOps. I know it's a lame joke, but still.
While working with a containerization platform, like hosting some kind of application on the Linux or Windows environment, how is it feels like hosting a Linux environment application and a Windows environment application?
So that is a pretty good question. To be very honest, मैं मेरे सर्कल में कोई ऐसा नहीं जो विंडोज पे डिप्लॉय करता हूँ, so I have no idea about Windows. Almost everyone I know and everyone I've worked with almost always deploys to Linux. So at Slab we use a very lightweight version of Alpine Linux, It's our own custom image. But again, sorry, mujhe nahi idea. Maybe, probably Kubernetes does support Windows, but again, I have no clue. Let's go ahead.
जिस तरह हम लोग कहते हैं इस पे Kubernetes के बाद सेल्फ हीलिंग पे काम कर रहे हैं इसी तरह इसको स्केल भी कर सकते हैं
एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली Kubernetes इज अ कंटेनर ऑर्केस्ट्राइजेशन टूल तो ये जो चीज आप एक डिप्लॉयमेंट बताते हैं तो कोई भी पॉड फेल होगा सही है आपके बेशक 1000 पॉड्स आपके प्रोडक्शन में 1000 नोड्स है कोई भी फेल होगा तो इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली ट्राई टू रिकवर इट
हां मेरे पास 100 पॉड्स हैं जो काम कर रहे हैं
ठीक है
और मेरी रिक्वेस्ट इतनी आ रही है कि मुझे 100 से ज्यादा चाहिए तो मैं एक और ऐड कर सकता हूं ऑन द रन टाइम
यस एग्जैक्टली इसमें आपको मैन्युअली भी ऐड करना पड़ेगा यू कैन स्पेसिफाई दीज रूल्स इन Kubernetes कि जब इस स्केल पे पहुंच जाओ तो जस्ट स्केल ऑटोमेटिकली अप टू दिस पॉइंट देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन
मेरा क्वेश्चन यानी कि ये है कि जिस तरह किस वक्त हमें पता स्टार्ट करना चाहिए कि हमें Kubernetes पे डिप्लॉयमेंट करनी चाहिए जिस तरह अगर बहुत छोटी एप्लीकेशंस होती है ठीक है अगर उसके लिए एक तो कोस्टिंग में भी हो जाता है कि अगर सिंपल एक मैन लिनक्स 1 GB वाले ले तो उसका डेटाबेस भी उधर ही हो जाएगा बैकग्राउंड प्रोसेसिंग सब कुछ उधर ही हो जाएगा तो एज कम्पेयर के इसके लिए मेरे ख्याल में डेटाबेस अलहदा से होगा
ठीक है
तो उसकी कोस्टिंग और कब हमें यानी कि डिफाइन हो
इट्स अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन और इंटरेस्टिंगली ये क्वेश्चन मुझे हमेशा पाकिस्तान में सुनने को मिलता है कि व्हेनेवर आई गो टू द यूएस और एनी अदर पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड They don't care about the cost क्योंकि उनको सरखुआरी नहीं चाहिए सही है तो it's a trade-off मैं बिल्कुल एडमिट करता हूँ GCP, AWS अगर आप उन पर कंटेनर्स एग्जीक्यूट करेंगे it'll be at least somewhat more expensive लेकिन सरखुआरी नहीं है तो आप it depends on you आप अपनी सरखुआरी पे क्या प्राइस टैग लगाते हो any other questions Yeah, I think that's it. Can you open the slide back again?
Excuse me? Over here.
Sorry? Yes.
Kubernetes load balancing is it managed kar sakti hai?
Sorry?
Load balancing.
Yes, of course. So, maine isme kafi cheeze miss ki hai. There's another concept in Kubernetes called services. So you can define your own load balancer service or usme aap bata do ke mere ye itne clusters hain itne replica and usme you can again define rules so jab bhi wo specific criteria meet karega ya aap usko automatic pe set kar sakte ho to automatically load balance all incoming requests according to your service definition
thank you
okay so I think there are no more questions you can find the first part of my talk at this url You can find these slides at this URL. If you want to reach out, you can always email me at hi@shyr.io. You can also find me on GitHub, where I'm super active. And that's it. Thank you.